Great to have you back on The Breakfast here on Plus TV Africa. Now, let's go back in history to the year 2012. It's one of the, events that basically has characterized and described America's, the United States of America, basically, in the last very, very long while. Mm-hmm. Only in 2021, there's been more than 300 mass shootings, more than 300, I think about 352 people dead, 1,300 injured in these mass shootings just in 2021, between January 1st and June 30 of 2012.
And some by teenagers.
Yes, absolutely. But on this day in 2012 was the Aurora, Colorado mass shooting. It happened in a movie theater on the day that the movie Dark Knight had a midnight screening of the movie Dark Knight Rises. It was carried out by a guy called James Egan Holmes, who walked into the theater, released tear gas, and opened fire on innocent movie lovers in the theater. Led to the death of 12 people, and about 70 people were injured in that mass shooting. The massacre began, you know, when, of course, he entered the theater through tear gas. He eventually also, I think later in the day, they found out that he also had some ammunition and had rigged his home with, bombs also. He eventually was arrested later that day by the police and was taken to court. And this is the craziest part. He pled guilty. He pled not guilty, I beg your pardon, as a result of insanity. Of course, he claimed, you know, a little bit of insanity, by reason of insanity, that's how it said. He eventually was convicted of 24 counts of first-degree murder, 140 counts of first-degree murder also, sentenced to life in prison without parole, and another 12 life sentences, plus an extra 3,318 years in prison. Of course, I believe still, is in prison till date. But 12 plus, one life sentence plus another 12 plus another 3,000 plus, years in prison is what he got after pleading not guilty by reason of insanity. But of course, this is once again, one of the incidents that has characterized. There's so many of them. There's the Sandy Hook. There's a couple of names that just became popular, mostly because of mass shootings in the United States of America. And like I said, this year alone, between January 1st and June 30, there's been more than 300. More than 300 lives have been lost to mass shootings. About 1,300 and, something have also been injured as a result of the same mass shootings. Sad. Very, very sad.
I think you can't talk about the mass shootings in the U.S. without taking a look at their gun laws, because they have, these gun laws that enable people, to get licenses to purchase guns for their own safety, so to speak. But the sad thing is how, let's even focus on the teenagers, how teenagers, go ahead to have access to guns that they're owned by their family, and they go to class, their teacher said something to them, made a comment about their hair, their looks, and they want to, begin to shoot people. They felt bullied by their classmates and they want to go ahead and, they feel justified, I want to shoot people. And I think the mass shootings further perpetuate the mass shootings, because people see it on the news and say, oh, this is something I can actually do. So I think, that's something that needs to be checked. Gun laws is something that has really divided, the Democrats, the Republicans in the U.S. It's a very dicey issue of debate. So when we come down to Nigeria here and we talk about gun laws and people saying, oh, because of the state of insecurity, we need to have gun laws. We need to have laws that allow Nigerians to have guns. We've seen, letters that have gone viral, people asking, for permission from the president to get guns to protect themselves. So it's just, really, how then would you say it in a country like the U.S. where we want to believe that they have better laws, they have a better system of administration, they have better protection, so to speak, but then they still have laws that enable them to have guns and people still go ahead to use that indiscriminately. In a country like ours, where we know that our laws and our infrastructure regarding security works different, what then do you say if we begin to have laws that allow people to have guns? What kind of situation or chaos might we descend into? And really, it's pretty
obvious that's the reason, Nigeria may not have, pretty much the same gun laws as the United States does. Their gun laws, do exist, but, they need to be tweaked here and there. The National Rifle Association, I believe, is one of the reasons they have not been able to make any major adjustments with the U.S. gun laws because of the politics involved and, the level of support. This, theories, the levels of support that some, candidates, both in their the Senate and, of course, you know, the presidency, most of the support that they get from the NRA makes it a little difficult. And also the politicization, the emotional connection that Americans have with their guns. But Nigeria, no. No, we're not there yet. It would be a disaster, complete disaster.
1973, July 20th, something shocking happened, and it was the death of Bruce Lee. He was an actor and martial arts expert. I mean, Bruce Lee has been a child actor, acting from as young as 1820. You know, he tried to make it in Nollywood, you know, but the U.S.
Hollywood,
the U.S. stage wasn't, you know, giving him that platform. So he returned to Hong Kong, focused on his martial arts career, and began to act films. He acted a couple of films. And then just when it seemed like he was rising and was getting to the peak of his career, you know, he had intervention from Hollywood, right? And, you know, he was going to, there was going to be a premiere of his first major movie. It was called Enter the Dragon. And then just all of a sudden, we heard the news that, you know, Bruce Lee had passed. At first, you know, they had said it was something that had happened to his brain. They had said, you know, regarding possibly an overdose of marijuana. But later on, they found out that it was a painkiller. His reaction to a certain painkiller, you know, drove him into a coma, and he couldn't wake up. It was just such a sad incident and a sad day today in history, July the 20th, 1973, when Bruce Lee died at a very young age of 32. And, you know, there was also a controversy that came up when Bruce Lee's son, Brandon, he was just 28 years old. He was also an actor. When Bruce Lee's son, following in his father's footsteps to become an actor, died in an accidental shooting on the set of a movie. So there was a movie that was being shot. It was called The Crow on March 31st, 1993. And he was accidentally shot to death at that scene. So that controversy that it was a family curse, that, you know, the father died at such a young age of 32, Brandon passed when he was just 28. It was just such a sad situation. I mean, when we look at the achievement of Bruce Lee, you know, you can't help but be marveled at, you know, just how much he has achieved, just how much he has accomplished, all the awards and all the honors. He was among Time Magazine's 100 most important people of the century. They talk about, you know, the experience he's had, the lifestyle he lived regarding staying clean. He would even eat and drink, you know, meat, you know, to say that would help him have more toned muscles. You know, he was just committed to the clean lifestyle. He was literally the fit fam. You know, he also got so many awards at home and abroad. In 1999, Bruce Lee was the first martial arts artist that was introduced to the Martial Arts Hall of Fame. Lots of awards, you know, that are too numerous to mention right now, and it's just sad that he passed on this day in history.
Yeah, at a pretty young age also, you know, was able to, you know, leave a very, very, you know, a lifelong impact, you know, with the time that he lived and the time that he, you know, was an actor and a martial artist. But fun fact about me, I never saw any Bruce Lee movie. Joined Earth in the era of Jackie Chan and Jet Li. All right, those are the ones that I
and that's why they would always refer to Bruce Lee, because it was one who combined both, and, you know, seeming to pave the way for other people to see that, oh, it's possible for me to do both. You know,
no, my era was Jackie Chan, Jet Li, Steven Seagal, what's the other guy's name, Van Damme, and Chuck Norris.
I never remember practicing those martial arts and breaking
a scar on my head.
Oh, yeah. That's it. Sorry about that.
All right.
Okay, let's take a break here. We just touched on two major events that happened in history, a mass shooting in the U.S. and the death of Bruce Lee. Let's take a break. We'll return to discuss issues regarding the Anambra governorship elections in November this year. Stay with us.